الله عليه وسلم: اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا وقلبا خاشعا وعملا متصدقا، اللهم اجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين الراشدين. وبعد، my dear brothers and sisters, I would like to thank you for giving me this great invitation, especially to the brothers, the youth. So inshallah, my topic there, the line goes with the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The nur that we need to look up to. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ كَمَثَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِّنْهَا.
So this nur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, one is the nur of the al-hidayah, the guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. And alhamdulillah, we have a lot of youth and a lot of brothers and sisters who are taking part in this nur. But always when we say conferences, it's very hard to bring out the people who actually need to know and listen to this part. The people that who actually need to understand what is actually nur and get out of the basement and come into the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول:
يا أيها الناس قد جاءكم برهان من ربكم وأنزلنا إليكم نورا مبينا فأما الذين آمنوا واعتصموا به فسيدخلهم في رحمة ورضوان وجنات وفضل.
This is the nur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بُرْهَانٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Evidence have come to you مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ. And we reveal to you what? نُورًا مُبِينًا. A manifest light, a clear light that you can see those people who hold upon it. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاعْتَصَمُوا بِهِ. And those who believed in it and hold upon, what is going to happen for them? فَسَيُدْخِلُهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put them in فِي رَحْمَتِهِ, His mercy. So, for us, we need to ask every time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this nur. Why we ask every time? The example of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the dua when he goes out, what he says, Allahumma ja'alni nura, Allahumma ja'al fi basari nura, wa fi qalbi nura. Why is so important? Because you want this guidance to keep staying on you. This light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to stay upon it. So al-munafiqun, on the day of judgment, what are they going to say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول
يَوْمَ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتُ لِلَّذِينَ من نوركم قيل ارجعوا وراءكم فالتمسوا نورا.
So that's why our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every time when he goes out, the dua of the morning, Allahumma ja'alni nura. We need to motivate ourselves and go on this path of the nur. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma ja'alni nura. Oh Allah, make for me a nur. And not to be those on the day of judgment who will be told, go back and gain some nur. So the nur is in this world that we need to take it from here and to the light, the hereafter, which is the deen and the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those who hold firm on this light that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, which is also the kitab of Allah, the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we have this nur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he calls a person that doesn't have this nur mate, dead. A person who's dead. فَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا. We make for him a light. يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ. That he can walk through the people. He can walk in it. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Are they equal, those who are knowledgeable and know, and those who don't? لا يستوون. They're not equal. So, when we look at this ayah, يا أيها الناس قد جاءكم برهان من ربكم. A proof, evidence came to you. Where we were asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for ni'mah, Allah has given us the ni'mah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the guidance of the Quran. So فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those that who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاَعْتَصَمُوا بِهِ, and they stayed firm on it. They didn't go away from it. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give them? فَسَيُدْخِلُهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will admit them fi rahmati, to his mercy. So many of us, we wonder, you know, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the people that kalbulumatin fi bahri lujiyya rashahu mawjun, or the other example of the Prophet of the Quran, that is it, ظلمات بعضها فوق بعض إذا أخرج يده لم يكد يراها. And then at the end, ومن لم يجعل الله له, ومن لم يجعل الله له نورا فما له من نور. Whosoever that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't give him this nur, guidance, Huda, Quran, Dhikr. Let's look at the Dhikr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكُمْ وملائكته ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور. ليخرجكم من الظلمات إلى النور.
From the darkness to light. أن العرب كانوا في جاهلية حمية الجاهلية. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أنزل عليهم هذا النور. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to them and gave them this nur, this beautiful nur of the Quran, the huda, the guidance. So whomsoever that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give him this nur, he should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. That's why you come out in the morning, say, Allahumma ja'alni nura. اللهم اجعلني في بصري نورا وفي أمامي نورا. So you should know now which light are you in now. Are you in this light part of it or you're out of it? We know ourselves. We know ourselves. Everyone knows where he's standing. So my dear brothers and sisters, if you look at the salah, as-sadaqah, as-salat nur, the salah is a light. Like the people who don't pray, salah, what's going to happen on the day of judgment? لَيْسَ لَهُمْ نُورًا. They don't have no nur. Why? Because one was, what was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's saying about the people, how he's going to know his ummah, how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is going to notify and identify his ummah by the wudu. So that shows it's a nur. So every time you make wudu, that's how we're going to have that nur. قال الله تعالى يوم تبيض وجوه وتسود وجوه فأما الذين اسودت وجوههم أكفرتم. So on the day of judgment, actually what's going to work is nur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, some of the people, Allah will give them this nur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يُعْطِيهِمْ هَذَا النُّورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the nur. Of why? Because they're making wudu. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his all nation, the people of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his ummah, don't have this light. If you didn't have the light, or you don't know that you have the light, then you should go back to yourself. Go back to and check. Do a checkup on yourself. Am I making proper wudu? Am I making proper salah? And I can talk about the nur of the Quran and the nur of the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. We can talk about all day. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورٌ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ. So this evidence, the Burhan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the guidance that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with, if we don't be thankful about it, then we'll be out. قال الله تعالى لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم. قد من الله إذ بعث فيهم رسولا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised among us a prophet. And we don't look at the things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, then it will be too late. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَكُونُ لَهُمْ فِي الْقَبْرِ ظُلُمَاتٍ. Among the people, when it comes to light, the people in their grave, there's darkness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from that. May Allah put in our qabr nur. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, nur of this life, nur of the guidance, nur of the huda, the nur of the tawfiq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the day of judgment, He will give certain people a nur. And certain people will not have this nur.
And this is just forwarding, putting a forward up to the day of judgment. We're going forward to the day of judgment. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us about the day of judgment. So reflect and think. Go back to yourself and say, do I actually have this knowledge? Did I actually believe in it? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what He will make for them? Nuran yamshibi. Yamshuna bihi. The light that they will go upon. So there will be a time that darknesses will be there. We're talking about the real darkness. Not just the jahiliya darkness that you will need on the day of Qiyamah, this nur. Now you see we're going to 2017, then 18, then 19. It goes on. Some people will get and work hard for this nur, and some people will not even have anything. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the nur, to give us the light في الدنيا والآخرة, in this life and in the hereafter. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you all light. اللهم اجعل لنا نورا. اللهم اجعل لنا نورا. ما لكم لا تقولون آمين. ما لكم كيف تحكمون. I don't say Ameen when you hear نور. اللهم اجعل لنا نورا. You know one thing is the Muslims يبخلون عنه. That they hold upon is the Ameen. You know. What I usually say, you never know there's an angel standing here saying Ameen too. Angel saying among us who are saying Ameen, but you say not Ameen. So actually there's a sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to say Ameen when a person makes a dua. Allahumma ja'al lana nura namshi bihi. Say Ameen. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the internal nur and the outside nur. That you can realize a person that, you know, he's not, you know, in drugs, he's not in suffering, he's not in the position of a loss. It's not in the position of sadness, but he's in the position of happiness. That's where the nur is. Happiness, that's where the nur, as-sa'ada, comes. That the person, you see him, that he's happy to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yakuna radiyan anna, to be pleased with us. And وجزاكم الله خيرا إلى حسن استماعكم. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the nur and the light. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.